This summer taught me a lot. I finally connected all the pieces of the DIY thermal energy storage system. The twin tanks, the radiators, and for the first time, warm water was actually circulating through the house. The concept worked, but not as well as I expected. The heat arrived, yes, but slowly. The tanks gave off only a few kilowatts, not enough to warm the house efficiently. Hi, Norbert here, energy engineer. In video number 116, I explain how to learn from lessons and restart even from zero if necessary. This is daily businesses in laboratories around the world. And even if it drives you out of the comfort zone, it can be a breakthrough to great systems. At first, I thought that the problem of underperformance was trapped air in the radiators.
That's air.
And there begins the water. Oh, that's black. Now it's clean. I spent some time bleeding these radiators with the help of the hose and the bottle system and used that to maintain a gentle overpressure. That helped, but only a little. The water flowed, the pumps were humming, yes, yet the radiators received too little power. Then the measurements told the real story. The coefficient of performance, or the COP, was 4. If I count the total cold plus heat energy that was produced and divide by the consumed power. If I use both heat and cold, then I can count both. As the dual heat pump consumed in total 1100 volts and the temperature of the cold warm tank decreased and increased 2 degrees per hour, I practically got a delta T of 4 degrees per hour or 4.8 kilowatts. And that was the performance of the heat pump in the tanks. That math trick is a privilege for who doesn't use the heat pump as the whole society does. Discard hot or cold? No, I use both of them. However, with 9 liters per minute through the pickup radiator, the temperature difference between inlet and outlet was only 3 degrees. That means less than 2 kilowatts of heat transfer. And that's simply not enough to heat a house. The principle of the system is right, but the scale is too small and the heat exchange surfaces are too limited. So this winter, in our other residence, where we'll stay until April 2026, I'll start from scratch. Version 2 will be completely redesigned using everything I've learned from this prototype. The first improvement will be the capacity. I'll use a larger, better insulated tank, around 1500 to 2000 liters, to store enough energy for a full day of heating. The goal is not just to store more water, but to store more useful heat. Keeping the upper layer near 50 degrees Celsius for stratification and consuming the heat from there. I want a tank with multiple coils to add heat from different sources, including a stove on biomass, the conventional natural gas boiler, or even CHP, as you can see in my playlist starting from video 75. I will see if I want to purchase or make such a tank, which is much used in Germany and in Austria. The second improvement will be to combine the heat pumps together. If I decide to do it like this summer, with one heat pump heating up the evaporator of the other, then I will not use any more a large intermediate tank because it's hardly necessary. I will instead look if I can find or modify a heat pump so that it can work at another temperature than its fellow. And of course, this must be easy to replicate also for you. I will in this way avoid the use of one storage or use that in another way. Inside the tank, I'll replace the submerged radiator with a plate heat exchanger. The radiator in the tank worked, but its surface area was too small and the heat transfer too slow. A plate exchanger allows higher flow on both sides and is very compact, efficient, and allows also a very compact, efficient heat transfer. On the home side, I will install fans on the radiators that can deliver the same room comfort even with 40 degrees water. Fans multiply the air movement and therefore the heat exchange. I already tested this in my very first video. Even if Tuscany is not Sicily, it is still above 0 degrees most of the time. So hot radiators are not a must. Control will also be smarter. The next system will include digital thermometers, flow sensors, and an intelligent pump controller. Instead of me guessing the right speed manually, the controller will automatically maintain a good temperature difference across the system. The small 12-volt pumps worked surprisingly well. They had no problem to provide a flow of 600 liters per hour. With a delta T of 10 degrees Celsius, that is 7 kilowatts. Already half of what I am aiming at. Remember that with a good storage, you can ask for higher peak power, even without having a heat pump of the same power. The 12-volt DC pumps with speed modulation can work on a car battery for many hours during a blackout. And then comes what I am most excited about, integration. In this new residence, I have no access to the roof, so no option for photovoltaic panels. But I plan to connect the system to biomass heaters, micro CHP, but also just making use of low tariffs, or anyway shifting the time of energy purchase, even if it were only to prepare for blackouts. I am also fascinated by the combination of heat pumps, and let them work at different temperature levels, so that the first heat pump in a cascade works between 0 and 30 degrees Celsius, while the second continues from there to 60 degrees Celsius. That will also open the possibility to prepare showers and water for the dishwasher and washing machine. But I will propose to you only if I can find simple enough methods to find those heat pumps or realize them by transforming standard heat pumps, for example by replacing its fluid with another one that has other operating temperatures at the same pressure. Finally, I'll make the system modular and well documented, so anyone following my videos and premium content can replicate it. The goal isn't just to fix my own system, but to create an open source model of home heating that others can build from affordable components, using energy that would otherwise be lost. Yes, this summer's experiment was a setback. The dual heat pump worked, but the storage and delivery side were underperforming. Still, that's exactly how engineering evolves. You build, you measure, you fail, you understand, and you rebuild smarter. So this winter in Tuscany, I'll build the improved version. Bigger, cleaner, smarter, and powered by multiple sources, so that you can choose. It will be a second generation DIY thermal energy storage, designed not just to heat my home, but to show that comfort and independence can be achieved with creativity, not with expensive equipment. So stay tuned, the learning continues. And I ask you now, if you like energy innovation at your home, to subscribe now so that you can contribute to the energy transition from the bottom and build your own energy independence.